today we're going to hook the fuel pump into the gas line and up to the carburetor through this little fancy clear view fuel filter that I got. Gotta pick the right fittings, hook the hose up. Real easy basic shit, but hey, it's hot. What do you want? You guys want updates? I got them.
Happen one of these days if your fuel pump goes bad. You have to change it, right?
Yep.
You're going to have fenders and core support and all that kind of stuff in there. What's going to be the best way to get to it?
Underneath.
If this clamp is facing down and you have to change it later, you get right to it. But if it was way up here like this, you're going to have to get belts out of the way and all that kind of crap, or use a tiny little screwdriver to get to it. And you're going to say, why in the fuck did somebody put this clamp facing this direction?
Gotcha.
Makes sense, don't it?
Yeah.
There you go, fuel lines, it's the fuel pump, it's the fuel filter, it's the carburetor, and it had enough hose left over to barely run the vacuum. It's the crankcase. Crankcase?
PCV, positive crankcase ventilation.
Positive crankcase ventilation, whatever. So there's your fucking update. All right, real quick. Something we thought of as we were putting in the new spark plugs so that we don't have that open to the air was the spark plugs were the same as every other FE, but the gapping is different if you're switching to an electronic ignition. So keep that in mind, whatever you're building. If you are upgrading to from a points distributor to an electronic ignition, check the gap. The gap will be different for the different kinds of ignition. This, we happen to fortunately use the same plugs, so it doesn't mean that we're out a set of plugs. We just had to make sure to gap them right. If we hadn't checked that, then we would have gapped them wrong. So keep an eye on that shit.